Hey guys and dolls, Wildcard Wednesday today, and last week, as y'all probably remember, I drew the card out of the mystical, magical jug of suggestions, and drew the one that said, horrible bosses, and I had put that in there, you know, of course, way at the beginning when I started doing these, because I'm sure I'm not alone, and sometimes it helps to share your misery. You know, like the misery loves company thing with other people. So I didn't get any comments on last week's or messages on last week's video about, you know, any horrible bosses you have. But I'm sure after you watch this video, your mind will remember horrible bosses and then you can share it in the comments below. So if that happens to you, I would love to hear from you. So, okay, just again to let everybody know, I'm 45 years old. And I had my first job when I was probably, I was driving, so I was like 17, I'm going to say, 16 or 17. And that was when I had my first job. And then I just sat down, like just before filming this, to try to remember, you know, all the different jobs I've had. And just from that point until now, not including all the businesses I have done on my own, and I didn't count all of them. I counted 14 different jobs. So I've had opportunity to experience a lot of different bosses and things like that. So I'll tell you as many as I can remember. I've made some notes here and one just came to my mind. So I'll start with that one and it's not on my list. But and then I'm going to try not to go too long because of course I could go for hours and hours on this. But I want y'all to be able to, you know, watch this and maybe get a laugh out of it if nothing else. Because I look back now and that's all I can do is just laugh. But my most recent one that I'll tell you about, and I was actually only there, I wasn't even there for like 4 or 5 days, and it was with a major department store, and I had taken it, a part-time job, or was trying to find a part-time job during the holidays, you know, to make some money and all this kind of stuff. Well, long story short, it was just the most ridiculous fiasco I've ever seen. You know, they, too much technology and not enough people talking to people. And, you know, email messages couched in, you know, anger and all this kind of stuff. And of course, I finally was just like, hey, you know what, I don't care. So I wrote back and I said, it should not be this difficult to, you know, work part-time for somebody and get, you know, get out on the floor and all this kind of stuff. So anyway, that I would say was my first, or not my first, but my most recent horrible boss experience. Okay, let me think. One of the... Okay, I was hired by a woman to help her, it was during, I was doing estate sales, moving sales and stuff like this, and she came to one I was at, and then she hired me, wanted me to help her at hers, which I did, and then she wanted me to help her in her own personal business, and I was like, okay, fine, not a problem, and, you know, she asked if I was an organizer and stuff, and I said, yes, that I am, and that's what she was mainly wanting. Note to self there. If somebody's hiring you to organize them, beware. But yeah, anyway, got to her place and she was literally a hoarder. Okay. I wasn't there long enough to find out if she hoarded, like, you know, leftover food and stuff like that. But I do know that she had dirty dishes in her kitchen. But long story short, you know, I had spent the better part of the week in her office specifically, because that's what, now again, she asked me to help her with this stuff, okay? So it wasn't like I was overstepping boundaries or anything. So I'd spent the better part of a week, Monday through Friday, in her house in the winter that she wouldn't turn the heater on. So of course I was, you know, shivering the whole time and it was just, but this was way back when I was a new single mom the second time. So I was desperate, of course, and when you're desperate is the worst time to take jobs. But anyway, needless to say, I came back the Monday after I had actually cleaned off a desk surface and, you know, I showed her and all this. And of course she immediately thought I had thrown everything away and I was like, no. And I showed her where everything was. And then she thought I had stolen money because I told her I was finding, you know, change and dollars and all this. And I had put it all together and she's like, well, where's the hundreds? And so she was making stuff up and everything. Needless to say, that one didn't last very long. Okay, so then there was another guy, a more recent one down here. Again, he had hired me as an assistant to work out of his home because supposedly at that point, he was employed and working out of his home. Well, then after I get with him and I do everything he says, he starts yelling at me because I'm doing what he says to do. Again, when people hire an assistant to work for them, they need to understand that assistant's going to do work. And if they don't like their stuff being touched, then they don't need to hire an assistant and ask them to touch their stuff. So then he made me move into the actual office across town, which ticked me off. And then I had to be there like a normal long day. So he'd already changed the agreement. And then he went out of town to Vegas, which he did a lot. Again, you know, note to self. And while he was gone, his father, who was also, co-owner in this jacked up scam of a Medicare supplement insurance program, which again, I didn't know what he did, you know, because that wasn't what I was hired for originally. I was hired to help him in his home. Well, the guy that hired me told me, okay, well, I'm going out of town, so I've told my dad that anything that he needs done that, you know, that you're supposed to help. And I'm like, okay. So then I go in to say something to his father. Now, mind you, this was just a couple of years ago, so I'm over 40. It's not like I'm 21. Not that that's justified, but this was a fairly recent thing. And I just told him, and I said, oh, hi, just wanting to, you know, make a little connection here, and I'm here, you know, just let me know if you need me to, you know, do anything for you. And he goes, yeah, so-and-so, and he said his son's name, told me that while he's gone, you're my beck and call girl. And then proceeded to do the chauvinistic, misogynistic, ho-ho-ho, you know, laugh. Okay, so that's another one. And these are just snapshots. You know, I could go on and on. I was hired by a kitchen and bath design place here in Austin that is no longer in business. And she basically, in the few months that I was with her, I brought in over $250,000 of revenue to her business, whereas the whole prior year she didn't even have a fraction of that. I had gotten her entire, you know, company organized, you know, and everything, and I thought we were having a real good rapport and everything. Well, then come to find out, someone else in the office, a young girl who liked me, and I was kind of mentoring her because she would ask me about, you know, design stuff, and told me that the woman that hired me was actually communicating with my ex-husband on the telephone. And long story short, she ended up accusing me of stealing from her and stealing her clients and all this kind of stuff, and ended up firing me. So there you go. Let's see. All right. I worked for an independent jewelry store in Denton, Texas. And this was I actually got the job from one of my only good bosses I ever had. Oddly enough, the only good bosses I've ever had have been in the jewelry industry, which is very interesting, as a matter of fact. But anyway, he had gotten me this job, and you know, it had come time for me to, you know, I was asking for a raise and the whole deal, because of course, being an independent company, there was no real, any kind of, you know, review time or anything like this. Well, I had outperformed, outsold, organized the store, cleaned up, found inventory that had been missing, thought stolen, you know, I found, you know, all this great stuff. And I presented my case, and he proceeded to, you know, we were in his office, and then he proceeded to walk like kind of to the doorway-ish of the office. In other words, where everybody in the store could hear him, and he proceeded to berate me and yell at me and ask me, who did I think I was? And did he even said this, he goes, do you think you can get better than this job? And it was literally just a little jewelry store on the square in Denton. So it wasn't like it was, you know, I wasn't, you know, like a brain surgeon somewhere. So that was horrible. Okay, I worked for a big box home improvement store, and was pregnant with my son, and they were doing a remodel. This was in Carrollton, Texas, and they were doing a remodel at the time, and the store manager was known to be super cheap, and he would do everything cheap that he could in order for him to get the year bonuses, but he would never share them with anybody else. That's not the big point of it, but I was big and fat and pregnant, and it's summer in Texas, And he refused. They were remodeling, so they were expanding the store, and we had gotten moved to the other side of the store with the kitchen and bath department. And he, you know, I was over there, and no AC or anything. And even the guys that worked over there were complaining about it being hot, and it got up to 96 degrees on a regular basis inside with no fans. And he wouldn't do anything about it. And I actually went in there with a thermometer that I had gotten from the lawn and garden department and showed him what the temperature was. And he just didn't really care. So, not that, you know, that, you know, it kind of, when I'm saying this stuff, it may sound to y'all like I'm kind of being a wimpy or namby-pamby or something. But there was a lot more to it than that. Like, for example, this same place, again, I had researched and figured out how much profit margin and everything they got, and I worked up this whole big report right before my year review, which, of course, all the men in this particular company always got raises, but the women never did, and I, you know, gave them every reason. And the assistant manager I was talking to, and he said, you know, well, if it was up to me, I'd give you X amount of dollars raise, but I can only give you 10 cents an hour raise. And again, I was outperforming, outselling, you know, and everything, getting all the, you know, customer service, she did such a great job stuff. And, you know, okay, another one I was in was in network marketing, and it was when I was just barely doing the business, and it was a guy, and he's still with that company and still making lots of money, and he hired me because he liked, you know, what I did and all this kind of stuff. And I ended up recruiting, you know, in the best week, 7 people in a week, which if you're in network marketing, you know that that's unheard of. So I did that. I had sold product to his existing clients. I had reenacted old clients of his and gotten them, you know, buying products again and all this kind of stuff. And he called me, it was like on Thursday, to congratulate me about how good and great, and it was all wonderful, and he was like making plans and everything. And then literally the next day, and I'm not exaggerating, literally the next day, he fires me over the phone, and I'm like, and so I just start packing up my stuff and leaving. He calls back and talks to another girl in the office, and then gets me on the phone, and again, and he's like, well, what are you doing? And I said, you fired me, I'm leaving. And he said, well, you know, you can stay until so-and-so time. And I'm like, you fired me. Why would I stay? So that made me mad and upset. Okay, there was another cabinet company in Carrollton that they hired me to catch them up on all these designs that had been, they were like 6 months, a year behind on design work and, you know, all this other kind of stuff. So I caught them up literally in a month's time of the design work. And it actually, truth be told, the other woman there, she just wasn't doing any work, because I got it all done in a month. And then things happen and issues happen, and the owner guy that had hired me then hired a, you know, an expert to come in and streamline the organization, even though there was only like 5 people, 6 people employed in the whole business. Well, then they changed it totally, so where I was no longer going to get paid. I was going to be commission only based on what I sold, and that wasn't what I was hired for, but that was okay. So I started selling stuff, and then they told me what the commission structure was, and I was going to have to sell like $3 million of wholesale price of cabinetry in order to make $25,000 a year. And anybody out there that's ever done commission, you know that that's ridiculous and unattainable. So I was basically going to work my tail off and get, you know, $5,000 a year. So that was a terrible one. And then I think that was everybody. I think that was all of them. So is anybody else as exhausted as I am talking about horrible bosses? I'm sure y'all have horrible bosses too. So I, you know, if you don't mind sharing the story, leave it in the comments below. If it's a little too personal, go ahead and leave me a direct message so we can commiserate with each other. But I've talked too much again, so let's get to it. This is the Mystical Magical Drink. And if y'all have a suggestion, send it in either direct message or comments below, and I don't want to look. And we will draw what is on next week's. If I can get one in my hand. Here's one in my hand. Here it is. All right, so this one says, decisions are hard until you make the decision to do it. So that should be a good one. Decisions are hard until you make the decision to do it. So if that one spurs you on to, you know, mention to me something that you want me to do in next week's show on Wildcard Wednesday, leave it in the comments below. Otherwise, that's it. And I know I'm talking really fast, but it's because I've talked too long and I want to get off so where y'all can go on about your day. So y'all have a delicious, delightful, delirious day. And I'll see you tomorrow. Goodbye.